Welcome to the Himbos Podcast, brought to you by Big Jim Productions and The Bonfire, making Himbros and Bimbros more awesome. If you thought the Himbos were nothing more than one-dimensional, womanizing, egomaniac gym rats with sick tans, get ready to have the hair pomade slapped off your meticulously sculpted coif on a hilarious journey of self-improvement for the body, mind, and soul. And now, to reveal the real sinew beneath the Himbo physique, your hosts, Justin Silver and Josh Adam Meyers.
We are the Himbos, we are not bimbos. 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 Himbo body, himbo mind, himbo souls. Velocities, himbo fashions, himbo fitness, himbo roomies, himbo science. We are the himbos, we are not bimbos. We are the himbos, we are not bimbos. We are the himbos, himbos, yeah. Come and gonna tell you how to do your hair.
Welcome to the brand new Himbos Podcast. It's your boy. You know. the original Himbo himself. Props to Marky Mark. It's your boy, Justin Silver, sitting across my co-host, the other HHIC, Josh Adam Meyers.
What's up? I'm just reveling in how good my theme song is.
It is awesome, dude.
I wrote that shit in 8 seconds.
Dude.
It came out so easily. No rough drafts, no nothing. That was just God's lips, my ears, into my phone.
Buddy, I loved it so much because it's like it clearly defines the difference between bimbos and himbos, of which we are not bimbos. This is a Himbos podcast.
We are going to totally tear down the word, man.
We are taking the fucking word back, my friend. Making every dude, all these listeners, you're going to be proud to call yourself Himbros and Bimbros. In the studio with us, of course, it is the Black King, our producer, Lewis Johnson. We have the always sexual DJ Lewitsky. Hi, Lou. You're looking fucking hot today.
All right, dude.
Wait till I regrow all your hair on this show. I promise I know how to do it.
Thank you.
And can you not say it in that voice?
Why?
Either? Like, go down like, yeah, I'm going to totally regrow all that hair.
Well, let me tell you, I get erect when I talk about a hair protocol.
Well, that is your thing.
And, of course, Christine Evans is with us. What's up, Christine?
Hi.
So, listen, me and Josh did a lot of thinking on the show. Obviously, you're going to get sick workout tips, sex playlists. I'll teach you how to regrow that hairline. But we're here to go deep, learn together,
yeah,
grow together. This mm-hmm. This is going to be a self-improvement journey of the body, mind, and soul for myself and Josh Adam Myers.
We're going to help every single listener out there that is like afraid to take care of themselves.
Yes.
And there's nothing wrong with it because I personally don't think I'm a himbo. Like, I'm just an addict that works out.
But that's my point. That's my point is like there are himbo-esque qualities to our personality. We're both into fitness. We take care of ourselves. So we're taking the word back because I think, like you were saying, Big J's a fucking himbo, and he didn't even realize it with his goddamn hair protocol and all his jewelry.
He is. I cannot wait until we get him, we can break his ass down and be like, see all those bracelets, bro? That's himbo, dude.
Dude, he's going to be walking around with a half-belly t-shirt and a rocker tattoo that says himbo. I promise. Dude, here's some of the things me and Josh want to do. We're going to bring expert guests in to break us down and mm-hmm. build us up on to every level. Dating, fitness, health, feng shui. You're way into that one, Josh.
I mean, now I am. Yeah. You know, I like space. I got the new apartment. I like to place nice things in it.
Well, you get into feng shui with the new apartment?
Well, I mean, I'm just calling it that.
You didn't like read a book?
Yeah. No, I didn't read a book.
No, we're going to read a book.
I took pictures and sent it to my ex-girlfriend. I was like, help me pick out shit to put up around here and over there. And
there will be required reading for everybody in this room and all the listeners, I guarantee, and I'm going to give tests. We're going to learn about anti-aging supplements.
Mm-hmm. Legal and illegal.
We're going to improve our mental health. We're going to take personality and IQ tests. We're going to get fashion tips. Sexologists are going to teach us how to be better lovers.
I'm excited about that.
I can use the voice for that one, right?
sexologists on to teach us how to be better lovers.
We're gonna, Josh and I are both single, so we're gonna learn how to make our dating app profiles fucking awesome.
We want to help everybody else out, because I think these are all questions that people, I hear from so many people, that they're like, it's like, I'm on all the apps and I'm not getting any matches. Like, what is the problem?
Or you match and it's not what you want.
I mean, it's, yes, for sure. I didn't want to say that. Okay, Cupid, just like really emphasize the word okay.
Fine, Cupid. Good enough for tonight, Cupid. We're going to give our producers makeovers. I can't wait to turn Jacob into Jacob Hottie Batati.
I want Soder to get him to stop dressing like a fourth grader on his first day of school.
Yes.
Don't you see what I'm saying? Like, it's just, if you put Soder in front of his house holding a sign saying, my first day of eighth grade,
he admittedly on a special says, I dress like a boy.
Yeah, he's got boy qualities.
I want to learn how to have something in my closet besides tank tops and just V-necks.
Yeah, you really ride those V-necks. Those were big into style in like 2009.
I want to learn and grow, buddy. If you go into my closet, let me tell you something. They're color coordinated. They look like a series of, like, you know, the most crayons you could ever get as a kid when they were like, "Fuck this! I really want this kid to be an artist." You get them like the 64 set.
Yeah,
that's what my closet.
And this is the
like.
Thing. This is the whole thing, everybody. I want you guys to know is that, like, this is why I think you are 100% a himbo. You are metrosexual.
Your
apartment is clean.
Sometimes.
You make smoothies. You have fresh berries, stuff like that in your fridge, a lot of different supplements. Like, I am a mess. I just am a good-looking guy that, you know, might take care of myself a little bit to kind of, you know, save my liver from complete destruction from all the drugs that I did years ago.
Here's what it is. I geek out. I definitely metrosexual it up. But I fucking geek out on, like, all the fitness science stuff. Like, I'll sit there and at night I'll go on YouTube. I'll start watching, like, David Sinclair talk about, like, and people ask questions about this, which I'm super psyched about. About, like, anti-aging protocols. I like to learn about, like, the different modalities of working out for, like, gaining strength. Endurance, hypertrophy. Like, I geek out on this shit.
I don't even know so, what any of that shit is.
Dude, we're going to get...
What the fuck is hypertrophy?
We had quit muscle size... Muscles getting bigger. The actual... Like, atrophy would be your muscle shrinking. Hypertrophy
you mean,
is your
wait,
muscles getting
you
bigger.
You could have just called it the swole, bro. Yeah, because that's what I call it, man. I got my traps is swole, bro.
By the way, there's the first drop that you have there. I watch Lou take it. I watch Lou take it.
My traps is swole, bro. I've never been more excited to sit down and talk about a bunch of meaningless shit.
I don't think it's meaningless. To your point, I think it's got a lot of value, and listeners are going to get a great amount of takeaway, and you get to laugh at us, and as we laugh at each other and learn how to fucking go through this shit. We're going to learn how to deal with our existential crisis.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm very excited. You know, I got, you know, a philosophy degree, so I'm ready to really help change people's lives. Like, we changed a friend's life the other night.
Who'd we do?
At the stand. I'm not going to say it, but I'm just saying, like, we want everybody. Basically, this is going to be a podcast of just, you know, there's nothing wrong with being a dude and taking care of yourself, taking care of your body, your mind, your soul. Just the theme song.
The theme song. Girls, too. The Bimbros are as important as the Himbros.
Yeah, but these words just sound so offensive.
But here's the thing. Because we haven't been here yet.
Yeah.
You're right.
You see what I'm saying? They haven't had a representative. They think Himbos are a bunch of brainless idiots walking around with their self-tanner, taking selfies. You and I got depth, bro. I fucking cry. I'm having a midlife crisis. I go to therapy.
Well, you're having it now? You're having it now at 44?
Shh. I lie about my age.
I had mine at
brother.
38,
did
dude.
You?
Yeah, I'm lucky if I get another 38 years. There's no fucking way you're getting another 44.
Fuck.
All the illegal supplements that we have done.
No, I take Well, there's between supplements and recreationals. We should basically go over how this show got started.
Yes. So, yeah. It was a really weird phone call.
Jay apparently was watching you, in his words, dominate the fucking gym. at Montreal.
I was just doing devil's press. I don't understand.
To me, it just sounds like you were having a normal workout.
Yeah.
What? The guy was jumping over the bars, doing muscle ups, fucking cleaning presses. I'm like, yeah, he was having a Monday. What do you want me to tell you? But according to Jay, you were fucking dominating in there. While Yamanika was lifting 5-pound weights, and you were like encouraging her while you're just like, you know, going out.
She needed it. She needed help. Is this what this is the workout?
Are you doing CrossFit shit?
Yeah, I always do CrossFit shit.
So good.
It's just so good. Yeah, so you do that.
Yeah.
And then you get down.
Yep.
And then they're going step by step on this. You need to like get to the meat and potatoes.
Yeah, I already fell asleep watching how slow these fucks are moving. I need a Josh demonstration.
There it is. That's a good one. That's a good one. Yeah, this guy, you can tell. Look at him, meaty.
Ugh, those fucking dude. The CrossFit dudes. When they say fittest on earth, that legitimately is. It is the perfect combination of muscle endurance, strength, and hypertrophy. And don't worry, this will all be defined in later episodes. But apparently, you were dominating the gym, and then Dan made the comment that you're such a himbo, and then they were going on a few episodes about how we should start a Himbos podcast. We got a phone call. You were out walking the dog.
I was walking the dog in the Lower East Side and about to do some you know, buy some, you know, raw Japanese denim. I call it denim. Raw Japanese. I can't get that word out.
Give it to me three times fast. Raw Japanese
denim. Japanese denim.
Again.
I was at Self Edge. Raw Japanese denim. There you go.
She stood on the balcony, equivocally mimicking his hiccuping and adamantly beckoning him in.
I didn't know anybody else knew that vocal warm up. She stood on the balcony, inexplicably mimicking him hiccuping and amicably welcoming him in.
She stood on the balcony, equivocally mimicking his hiccuping and adamantly beckoning him in. Chinese Japanese denim.
No, it's raw Japanese denim.
Raw Japanese, unique New York. But we got the call and we were like, dude, we kind of brainstormed over the weekend. We're like, yeah, let's do this show. This should be awesome.
This is all stuff I'm interested in.
A minute ago, you weren't.
No, I didn't like the term himbo. It took me a while. And then
Josh
also,
is in denial. That's what's going on. Josh is in crazy denial about being a himbo. It's like me, I don't like the word slut. I don't like the word bisexual, but I am a bisexual slut.
You know what it is? Here it is. It was when we were talking and he was like, dude, we're actually going to redefine it. We're all still stuck on the old connotation of the word.
Yeah.
So the process of this is like, we're going to be proud. We're going to own this shit. We're going to own it.
We are. I was like, am I going to be working with Justin Silver for the next 8 years?
Yes. With the anti-aging protocols we're going to teach you, we're going to live to be 180. So it's going to be a lot longer than that, Josh.
This is going to be me and Justin in like cryo freezers, just like, all right, it's time to do an episode, guys.
But
I don't mean to go off because I know that's not the topic for today, but you just said anti-aging a couple times. Have you guys heard of this new NAD-IV therapy or NAD-IV therapy?
No, but no. I don't want to see anything that the Jenners are doing.
The richest people in the world, you don't think they have the secret to anti-aging? You think you know better than the Jenners?
Oh well, I don't think
I know better. But this is a podcast by the people for the people. I want a all right.
They're my people.
They're your.
They are her people. Okay. Also, they're close friends of mine.
NAD-IV therapy.
Close friends to Josh.
Worked with them for 2 years, guys.
Are these the vitamin B? Are these the vitamin B and adrenaline shots, which I get prescribed by a sports medicine doctor, which are fucking great, Josh? That's the loudest vape I've ever heard in my life.
You did the same thing, dude.
Does mine sound like that, though?
Yeah.
Is it disruptive?
No.
DJ Lou?
I find it calming.
Calming. All right, listen, I am not... This is a fucking democracy here. This is a democracy here. I do not mean to...
I vape.
It's good for longevity.
I'm going to tell you right now, if we're doing multiple episodes of this, you need to bring your own fucking vape.
I have it.
Every show.
I bought it specifically so that we don't
ever
have a redo.
You don't need it because you can't vape in studio anyway. So you're vaping outside.
Okay. Yeah. We're not vaping.
We're recording outside. I'll be smoking crack in the studio if I want to. Okay. So I have not heard about that, but I cannot wait to learn about it, Christine. About the IV drips, we're gonna do experiments. I'll do an IV. I'll do one of those drips on air.
They're $800, but I think we should all do them.
I'll do it.
We're doing experiments.
Do we have a budget?
I'll put my own. Listen, I'm willing to invest my own money into this kind of thing.
I'm a trust fund kid. Can I just say that money's got to get spent somehow, somewhere? It's going now. I'm joking. I'm joking, Josh.
Nah, I've always been wondering how you get
I'm
your
not.
Money, dude.
No, I'm, I'm Jewish. Yeah. I save. I invest in the S&P 500.
It's your dad that didn't love you. You have money from him.
No, my dad had no money. My dad died dead fucking broke. I have zero money from. Put on some sad music for me on this one. Put on some sad music. No. Crank that one up. I did get money from the bar mitzvah, but let me explain something. That money went to send me to therapeutic boarding school so I didn't have to go to detention center, which cost $60,000 a year, and then I broke out of it. I'm a fuck up. So, no.
You got over $60,000 for your bar mitzvah?
Here's what happened. It was one of those bar mitzvahs where, like, my mom owned that company. She owned her fashion company and invited everybody there. So I, like, knew nobody there. It was basically going to make the money for my college tuition. And then it just went to send me to boarding school when I was, like, threatening to kill myself when I was, like, 14 because I hated school. And I didn't go for 60 days. So.
Way to bring it down.
Yeah, I didn't bring it down.
I know, dude. I'm bringing it, be helping
I'm
people.
Bringing it real. But no, we're going to tell you how to get. We're going to tell you how to go from that to get to your 40s.
Years.
I'm telling you that I'm a Jewy Jew boy, but I'm one of the most least Jewy Jews in Jewville next to Josh Adamine.
Also in denial.
Yeah,
I am in denial.
You're way more Jewish than I am, dude.
I am way more Jewish than you, but I'm still very un-Jewy. We'll have an episode.
You're just
on
comparing
that.
Yourself to like Hasidic Jews in New York, like to the rest of the world.
I'm comparing myself to Ari.
Do you know when like Rosh Hashanah is?
When my mom calls me and says, "Hey, it's Rosh Hashanah."
All right. Yeah.
I know none of that's the same. When my mom's like, "You have to come for Rosh Hashanah dinner." I'm like, "Is that the one without the bread or the one with the bread?"
You know the holidays, dude. We all know the holidays.
Rosh Hashanah's got the good food. I know that. Passover's got the shit.
I don't know if you call like brisket shit. Matzah brah is not shit.
Matzah brah is a shit. Dude.
Yom Kippur is the one that's where you just cry all day, right? You repent.
That's every day.
But what an incredible like being a Jew. It's just you can do whatever the fuck you want all year, 364 days out of the year. But on that last day, just go to temple, gone.
Yeah, you can fucking.
That's literally Christianity every day.
All right, man.
You know what? don't get anti-Semitic on this podcast. Yeah.
I'm just
Christine.
Telling
this
you
is
about
us.
The Christians.
This is about us. We're gonna give Black Lou a bar mitzvah on this fucking show. You circumcised, Lou?
Absolutely.
Can we do it again?
No.
Fuck. I'll do it again. All right, dude. Let's start with some fucking depth.
Can I before he even gets into this topic? You're leading this one because you were so excited. You're like, all right, first topic. This is what we're doing. 100%. We got to get right into it. Go ahead. Go ahead, dude. I can't. And he started talking about his protocol.
When you do the Justin voice. It's awesome because it's the Josh Justin voice. Everyone else goes it like, wah, wah, wah. Do it again.
It's like, I can't do it off the top of my head.
You
it's got to be like.
I can do Josh like, Adam Myers.
I sound nothing like that. You gotta put the like Marilyn that. Twang in there. Marilyn, you got to go lower.
Okay, Marilyn Twang in there. You got to go lower.
That's not always sound.
Christine?
I mean, it was better the first time.
Yeah.
You know what it is? You can't
take direction.
You can't squander my creative process. Go ahead, Josh.
I'm so excited to talk about this.
Nailed it. Nailed it.
I'm so excited. Because you know why? You sound exactly like my Uncle Bob. He'd be like, Josh, you're coming over for Passover? We're doing it and your mom's making the brisket again. All right, go ahead, dude. This is the one you want to start the show off with. Here we go.
Can I get some music? Go back to Marky Mark.
I feel like that could be the music. Every time we drop a new topic, that should be like, boom.
Dude, he's the original himbo. He's who I want to be.
Here it is, dude. Drop it.
First topic of the Himbos podcast. The long-awaited, the depth of this topic... Manscaping.
Oh my God.
Manscaping, baby. Josh, listen, everyone's got a protocol. Mine may be a little bit more in depth than most. I'll go through it. I had to take notes on this because I did it today, because I wanted to give people some serious takeaway on this one.
You had mentioned to me just a taste of what you do, and I thought it was ridiculous.
It's not ridiculous.
You do something that I do, and when I told Josh I do it, he was like, yeah, but you're a girl.
You're a girl.
And I do agree with it.
We're talking about the toe part.
We're talking about the toes.
We'll get to that at the end. Let's keep everybody salivating.
You just mentioned it.
No.
You mentioned it.
No, because there's people who are going to tune out, and now they're going to be like, what's the toe thing? I'm keeping them in.
All right, good.
There's an order in the way that I do it. I'm going to explain the order.
Go ahead, dude.
Okay, so the point of this is, like, listen, everything's got to look natural, right? The estate has got to be well manicured, right? Shrubbery, where there's supposed to be shrubbery, no weeds along the pathways. That's what I think about.
I don't disagree with what you're saying.
Yes.
But there is, you want to, like, men naturally have body hair. So you want to keep it within the realm of reality, where it's like, if you look like a fucking sea porpoise, like, you know what I mean?
Dude, 100%. There's time. Listen, I'm not a hairy dude. So there's times I'll grow shit out and be like, I'm going all natch, baby. There's times I'm doing that. But if I'm looking for some fucking sick definish, you're going to lose that unless you're shaved down. So sometimes I shave it down.
All right. So what's your full protocol? Like,
this is me going all out here, which doesn't always happen, okay?
Go for just normal day-to-day, because I really want to know.
On the normal day-to-day, I'll let things ebb and flow. So I like what you're doing, where you're giving me, like, give me stakes.
All right. So just normal.
Hang on.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Hang on. Theme music while we're talking about the stakes.
I think the Monday through Friday is all, like, maintenance. I think what we want, like, what is shave-down routine?
Correct. Yeah.
What you have to do? Like, what's your cycle?
What's the Super Bowl?
Because I'm quick. I'll do me very, very quickly. This is what I do.
Please.
I have a very hairy chest, and it's also, because of my age, it's gray.
It looks
and
great.
And my trauma.
You look like Wolverine. Josh, you know, you look like Logan.
My chest hair looks like Pangea. Does that make sense?
Can I see it?
No, I've shaved it down. See,
that looks fucking... So, Josh, you're buzzed right now. That looks fucking great.
I wouldn't call this a buzz cut. This is like a six. This is a six on my razor.
Wait, Lou, let me get under the light so the fucking... So you get the definite... All right. Wow.
I'm just
did you get erect?
You don't need to see my abs. This is just regular. So what I do is I trim it down. I take a six. I have clippers. My friend Justine Marino gave me what I don't we hopefully we get them as a sponsor. Manscaping.
Man groomer,
whatever.
Which one?
No, it's just like the regular one. The one that you can put on your balls and your chest.
Not
and,
the Man Groomer Lithium Max Plus with the flexing heads?
I really don't know.
Well, they're gonna be a sponsor, so you're gonna know.
So send me she gave me everything, like the ball lube, all this shit.
I didn't know about that.
So what I do is I trim my chest down to with a six, but I keep all the hair, and then I kind of, when I get down to, because Big J was the one that told me that I show a lot of top bush,
so
I trim my
Big J the himbo?
The himbo.
Okay.
I trim my top bush down a little bit, get that a little closer, and then I just do my balls. That's it. I do my balls and my shaft, and here's the thing. Even though it says it won't cut you, like, it cuts you. If you are ever tired, people, and you need to wake up, shave your balls, because if one of those things zaps it, it'll hoe.
Can I give you the irony of this?
What?
When I took the actual Gillette razor, like the vibrating razor, that the reason that thing cuts you when you use like a buzzer or a clipper is because it catches the skin. You got to go with a face razor on the balls and the ass. And yes, ass is included in this. When I go through this protocol, you'd be shocked. You pull that skin tight, you're not getting a nick, baby. But that thing's going to catch those hairs.
Yeah.
That thing is dangerous. Dangerous.
That's what I do. That is all I do. I cheer my chest down. Mm-hmm. I shave my balls. I make the top bush look a little bit more contained. And I'd say, you know, kind of like a, like it's just, you know, like a nice like groove over top, like a nice mane, nothing out of control.
Yeah.
But that's only been for a few years now. I'd say for about a year now, I've really been doing that. I just let it grow wild.
This is all preference and choice. By the way, the choice you're making is a fucking beautiful choice. I think it works for you. I wouldn't even suggest, there's different types of himbos out here.
I know.
But right? I wouldn't suggest that people who are more of, your kin, your type of himbo, go my protocol. Some people are going to go Josh. Some people are going to go the Justin.
You can take care of yourself at any level.
At any level, you can take care of yourself.
I have hairy calves.
Go ahead, Lou. Yeah?
What do you himbos do for your lower back? Because that's a hard one.
Oh, shit. I forgot to put that in.
Go ahead.
I do.
So back more hair. Gets revealed about Josh's protocol.
Thank you, Black Lou. So what I do is, if I can get a girl to do it, I get her to shave my back.
Oh, that's
if
a turn
not,
on.
Wait, with a Bic?
With no. I use the razor, the electric razor. And then if I can't get a girl, then I do it. But I get pretty good job, but I know there's just like a fucking mohawk stripe down the back.
Wait, Josh.
Down the center of my back.
Do you not have the man groomer that's the whole point of it is that it's got the extended champ. You can like, it's like a back scratcher.
I'd rather go get waxed if I'm going to do
but
that.
But what man groomer do you, just have like a man groomer, like a shaver?
Like a little, like a little clippers.
Oh, buddy.
Wait, you've had your back waxed?
Yeah, I've had my back waxed twice. Dude, you want to hear how douchey this shit is? When
yes.
I first moved.
Yes.
When I first. Yeah, you get
more
so
than
excited.
Anything I do. Because here's what I'm learning. You and I are so much more similar than you want to be.
Yeah,
to
Josh
me.
Is like,
Josh,
I'm not.
No. Josh is like, I'm nothing like Justin. I'm like, you are so like Justin.
Because I have regular fucking feet.
Go ahead.
I don't leave it
flip
like.
Flip out.
I just
flip
leave
out.
My fucking regular feet. You're shaving it down. Like, you got into a relationship.
Don't talk about the feet yet.
I didn't realize you have Samwise Gamgee feet. Jesus.
Wait till I fucking take my shoes off at the end of this.
We're taking it.
Lou, I want this on social media. I'm taking a picture of my fucking toes. I want them rated from 1 to 10 by the Bimbros. Go ahead, Josh.
So what I did when I was getting ready to move to LA 14 years ago, I got my back waxed,
yeah,
and then I told her to wax my chest, which was the most painful thing I've ever experienced in my whole life. Like the 40-year-old virgin, 100% true.
How hairy is your back?
It's not bad. I could leave it.
What does it have, that
fine.
Patch like right above... Like
no,
in the tramped up area?
It's like, it's just, it's not thick. It's not like it's, you know, there's like a couple hairs on my shoulders, but my back has just got like a slight fur.
Like a baby seal.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but nothing bad. And so what I try to keep that down. I try to like change that down as much as I can too.
Good. Good. Keep talking. Are you done?
That's it, bro.
That's it.
That's all I do.
Okay, here we go. Holy shit. Look at this guy on the screen. There was a guy in the gym like that the other day. I couldn't fucking work out next to this guy. He looked like, it looked like Bob Marley's hair if it were in like an oil spill. He was like sweating and it was like, dude, there was like a current to the way his hair was flowing on his shoulders and arms.
Yeah, mine's nothing like that.
The problem is when you do this, it doesn't grow in right. If you just sort of shave it down, it grows in kind of fine again. When you go, this gives you like bumps and shit when you do the waxing. I do not suggest the waxing. I don't suggest it. It's not necessary. It really is not necessary. I did Mike Harrington's. I did Mike Harrington has a very hairy back. It's actually on my social media post. He got in my bathtub, and boy, did I have to unclog that drain like I fucking bathed the St. Bernard afterwards. But I did his whole back with the Man Groomer Lithium Platinum Plus, and he looked glowing.
Well, so what is your? Okay. I really want to know if we are so similar. What is your protocol? Because I really don't. And nothing. Not a knock on you.
I don't think you're knocking me.
You're just very well kept. Do you know what I mean? Yeah,
I take it as a compliment.
Yeah, you're like everything about your apartment's spotless clean. Mine's got fucking fur and like, you know, if you lift up the toilet seat, there's probably a little doodad
there
hanging
was.
There.
There was. Yeah. I went. I have dog hair on everything, which is a problem.
Yeah.
But we both do. We're dog people here.
Yeah.
We'll have to come up with names for the dog bows or whatever we're gonna call them, the pooches. Okay, so here's what I'll do. So I go with the Norelco, which is similar to what you're doing with the man groomer. On the armpits, I go 3.
You trim your armpits down.
Because you know what's gross? And women will attest to that. When the armpit hair, like if your arm is down and the armpit hair like is visible, like coming forward from the front. You know what I'm saying, Christine? If my arm is like down right now and you're like,
that's gross on a guy.
You would trimming your arm hair down?
I'm sorry?
You're saying trimming your arm hair?
I'm saying like if a guy's like arm hair is showing through his arm, that's not something where I'm like, ew.
Well, I'm talking about the tens I date, so sorry. Drop number 2 in the can. Lou, I'm fucking giving you everything you need on this first episode. Okay, so I go number 3 there. Then on the regular pubes, I go number three also. So there's got to be fucking hair there. You can't shave that shit bald.
That looks weird.
Ridiculous.
Yeah, if there's any Himbros out there and you're shaving it all the way down.
Dude, I know dudes that do that. That's gross.
You can leave a little bit to the separation, because it really does make your dick, I think, look bigger.
A little. Yeah.
Don't pull your dick out,
I'm not. I'm saying you want like almost
I
want
to keep doing this podcast and not get banned.
We're not getting banned. You can't band awesome. There's another one. Okay. So I do that, right? Then I take then I go into the shower, right? And, oh, I'm sorry. Then I take the Man Groomer Lithium Platinum Plus. And if I'm keeping things up, I don't have to do this unless I've let things grow out. Because sometimes I like it natural. Things grow out. It's kind of sexy. I like a little, I'm not like a Tom Selleck, but I have a little less than what you have. Right? So sometimes I let it grow out. I'll take the Man Groomer, I go across the body, and then the great thing about the one I have is that it does the back too. It's like this extended thing. Can we bring it up on the screen, please? Because we want to be sponsored by them, and we want to do contests where we give this shit away. So I do the back with that thing. Then I get in the shower, and I get the Gillette Power Razor.
You have multiple attachments. It's the one.
No,
I have one thing.
It's the one I shave my face with.
Is this it, Justin?
Yeah, there it is. Is that the litany? Look at that. There it is. Boom. Flexible head. Different types of heads. Josh, look at that. You don't have to. Look how you get the reach on that.
That's
thing.
The equivalent of like a body hair Flo-Bee.
Yes.
If you remember.
It's like, awesome. It's awesome. It's fucking. It's pretty.
You like
awesome.
It?
Lou, you use
really?
It?
Really?
Do you use it, Lou?
No, but I would. It's the first time I've ever seen it.
Do you have back hair?
I got a little back hair.
Got a little
more
back
lower
hair.
Back, but I got short T-Rex arms.
Right.
So I really do need that.
Yeah.
I want to know how black guys go about this, because it's a different density of pube down there. So we have to give solutions for it, because there's black Himbos too.
All different flavors.
There's black bows out there that need to know this.
All right, don't give them a name, dude.
Why not?
I don't know how
bows, is that bad?
Yeah, dude.
What?
thank you for listening to the first and last episode of Himbos, guys.
Hey, black bows.
I think it's.
Why are you swinging at me?
No, I think it's beyond acceptable. So then I take the Gillette razor,
and
I don't like Gillette because they test on animals, so I get like the Amazon version of it that doesn't test on animals.
Nice.
But it's similar enough, okay? The secret is to use either a shaving gel or just use hair conditioner. So I lather it up, then I shave the chest, then I do what you do. You can't just have a straight line. So you have to do like a little bit of a fade, right? So I'll shave like the inner thigh areas, then this is so simple. Go over the balls, and then I do the asshole and the taint. It takes 2 seconds.
I don't do that. I don't do that.
Dude, I imagine if I'm with the chick, I'm on all four. I want to just be like, wow, this guy is fucking, wow.
I just, I don't want to, I don't know, I just.
What?
Wait, so you shave your chest with the Man Groomer, and then you do a shave gel Bic after that?
Christine, look at this. I'm showing you what we're doing here. This is the end result. You see this?
But did I get that right?
If I have to take it down at first, right? Are you under good? Am I under good lighting? Because I want to go under the top lighting so it doesn't look flat, Lou. If we're gonna do it, I want you to see the definition. What I'm saying is, if it's hairier, if I've let it grow out, I'll go with the Man Groomer. But if it's just normal upkeep like today, and I'm just doing the shave regularly, I don't have to do that. It just comes in. It doesn't come in stubbly on me, right? Because of the vitamins and minerals I take.
How often are you doing that?
Once a week. But it depends. You know, I've been depressed a little bit lately, so it's been like a little wild. You know, I haven't been keeping up the mansion. People All right. have been like, is this place condemned? What's he doing? I'm not done.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
So now we're clean. Now we're all clean. And then, and this is very important, Josh, I think you think the toe situation is excessive, but look at this. You see these little parts of your toes
That's
right here?
That's supposed to be there, man. You're a fucking dude.
Yeah, but you know what? I'm still a dude. I have foot hair. Right, and they're like, "Wow, you have like."
Are you swimming in a relay race?
You have
like,
really
what are
nice
you
feet.
Doing?
I have nice. I have nice feet.
Michael Phelps doesn't shave his feet.
Well, that's why he's not going as fast as I'm going
he's,
in the pool.
He's the greatest swimmer in the history of swimming.
No, that other chick who's winning everything now is, I think.
Michael Phelps. No, come okay. on, dude. He's a himbo.
Well, he's a pothead. I take only vitamins and minerals.
Okay, you.
Josh, so I do the, so it takes 1 second. I just do the digits of the toes, and then I get out. I get in front of the mirror. I'm like, did I miss any spots? And that's it.
Why are you shaving your feet, though?
That's, I don't shave my feet. I just do the. I just do
your
the,
toes.
The
edge, the, that's a, that's part of the foot.
Because you know why? If I'm out there with like a, some chick, maybe she wants to put them in her mouth.
It's your, but it's your foot. Who cares? It's a little bit, dude. It's a, how hairy are your feet that you have to trim it down?
They're not. They're not. It's just, Josh. When you, let me ask you a question. You had a nice Porsche, right?
I had.
You had a nice Porsche, right?
Yeah.
You take the thing to get washed, right? You take it to get detailed.
Yeah.
It's kind of nice when the guy's like, hey, I did a little something extra special and I put the armor all on the steering wheel too.
Why would you, I don't think any girl is going to fuck you because she sees no hair on your
it's
toes.
It's not that she's going to fuck me because she sees no hair on my toes. It's when she's fucking me, she's like, you know what? Little fucking thing here, he had nice toes.
I think he's gay.
They don't think I'm gay. They don't think I'm gay. Listen, man, I own this shit.
Should I be fucking him? Am I going to get monkeypox?
No, I'm not gay. I think my protocol is pretty on point. It's legit. It's not. I don't even think it's that excessive. It's not all that different than what you do.
Jay's family used to have, like, I don't know how often they did it, but everybody would get together to, like, shave down his step-pop.
Yeah.
So, but he,
by the way.
Hold on. In his defense, he was, like, a power lifter. Wasn't he a bodybuilder?
Yeah.
So that he's a bodybuilder. You're a fucking comic.
What?
You're just a Jewish comic that works with dongs.
You saying I'm not a bodybuilder?
You're not.
You want me to walk out of the show right now?
I am in 10 times better shape than you are.
You're in fucking phenomenal shape.
Wait until we do a fitness challenge on this thing. I am going to fucking sun you, dude.
I just got over a broken leg and I have a torn rotator cuff.
And
fuck you.
And you fell at a dog park. It wasn't,
that's not
like,
what happened.
It wasn't like you were doing, you know.
I wasn't. That's the irony,
Justin,
of the whole thing.
I watched the video of him hurting his foot like 10 times.
It's insane.
I still don't get like how he hurt it.
It's insane.
Like, am I missing it?
The irony of it is insane. I was on a hill that was rubberized with my dog. It's like this hill that kids can roll down, and I just rolled my ankle, and I was like, shit, I think I sprained my ankle. Next thing I know, this thing's like broken and fucking four places.
It was the ghost of a dog that you upset. Just like, just fucking knocked your ass over. I think the listeners would probably like to find out is, what do women actually want as far as male maintenance? Because are we doing the right thing? Or are we like going overboard?
I think it's unfortunately case by case.
It's case by case.
Some
it's
women like hairy guys, some women like hairless guys. I know that for me, it kind of changed as I got older. Like when I was younger, I wasn't really attracted to a guy with like chest hair at all. But then as I got older, my attraction kind of changed, where now I'm not really attracted to like a hairless chest anymore.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's also like,
you're saying you don't want to fuck me.
You have hair on your chest. You get rid of it.
Sometimes I do. See, this is what I'm saying. I'm flexible.
I think
I'm multifaceted. I'll go hair, I'll go no hair. Maybe these toes, maybe I'll fucking dread these toes if I want to and put beads in them.
I mean,
by the end of this episode,
crazy.
Who knows what I'm going to do?
I think most women are kind of what Christine wants, which is the older they get, they really start appreciating chest hair because it is a very manly thing. That's why I don't want to go bare.
Got it.
Do you know what I mean?
Like, 100%. You don't want to go bare, you want to go bare.
I want, yes.
Is that how we're saying it?
Yeah. You don't want to go bare, you want to go bare.
That's number four, Lou.
Because I've noticed women when we're hooking up or whatever, like they like to rub my chest.
I've had girls who've been like, why don't you grow this shit out? It turns around. I'm like, no problem. I'll go like this. I'll be like, here, play the woman in this scenario. Say, why don't you grow this out? I like it.
Why don't you grow this out? I kind of like long hair.
No problem, baby. I can do that.
That's how you talk. You sound like you have Bell's palsy.
No problem. The Nair paralyzes my lips. This is fucking flying by.
What is our final? So I think we're trying to tell people, like, you need
okay.
to maintenance.
I see what you're saying.
Especially if you're single.
Right.
If you're a single guy, like, women appreciate it. They really do appreciate it. Don't let it grow wild.
Right. Like, so I think what we're saying is, if you have, like, listen, absolutely, the pubes can't go wild and you can't let the grass grow up around the telephone pole.
You
can't have, like, dick shaft hair. You cannot. You can't. Christine?
You can't.
You cannot.
It's nice when it's gone.
Okay. You can't have dick shaft hair, which means you also have to take your pubes down a little bit. Don't go bald with them, right? and they have to somehow fade. You can't just have like a hard line where it's like you look like, you know, a Spanish Dominican guy's like front hairline. You can't have that.
I also, right? I'm going to fucking be open book right now. I like to leave a nice amount of pubes on both sides so I can fucking twirl them, yeah. Dude.
You need a fidget spinner. You get anxious.
I like...
Amount that I sit and twirl my bush hair. It's insane.
I just sit in the bathtub and I just fucking like dread them up like fucking. Yeah,
you
Pete
need
Tosh.
It's like a fidget spinner. You need something handsy to play with. Yeah. But okay, so we agree that you have to take the pubes down, right? Balls, I think like you can't have like ball hair.
Balls need to be clean, dude, because you want a girl to be able to put her, you know, the whole dick area. It's
or
like,
men. There's gay himbos too.
Yeah. I'm just saying, I mean, I bet gay men are probably
the best.
Yeah, because that's you. Because they're you.
I basically have
you're
a gay doing, man's
you
protocol.
A gay man
I do.
Protocol,
I do.
For
I do.
Sure.
I
your
do.
Butthole's clean so the dick can go right in.
I don't. Listen, I do not have sex with men. I'm being honest about that. But I do, because I live in Chelsea, I do look at the fucking gays and I'm like, these motherfuckers are on point. And
they're
manly.
Yeah.
They're manly. I don't think if you have very hairy arms, like Josh, you have like arm hair, but like it's that you're like, to me, you look like Wolverine, like Logan. You know what I'm saying? Like
thank
you're
you.
That type of guy. Like if you look like a what's his name? The Hangover and
Bradley Cooper.
Bradley Cooper. He's got chest hair. Like that's like the that's fucking appropriate. If you look at if you look at when he plays Logan, why can't I remember anybody's names right now?
Hugh Jackman.
There's a chest-haired guy, right? That's fucking great. Then there's times you want like the fucking Mark Wahlberg look. I'm more in that sort of
vein. But that's just unnatural on us. And I think like we have to work with what
you have to work with who you are,
and
yeah,
what you have.
Exactly.
And it's like if you're gonna, that's why I'm saying it's like if you're thick chest hair and you're shaving it down,
that's not
bare,
right.
It looks weird.
It's not right
because then it gets stubbly, and yes, then and you have to maintain it constantly because a woman hates that.
You have to be who you are and take care of the estate that you live in.
Yeah.
I would be, as a woman, giving any advice, like the back waxing
No. And
all that and stomach waxing and the like bick shaving, like I would say just use the tool. I really want to promote that tool that you gave because I'm
great.
Like, if you feel like
we're
you
not
need
promoting
to wax,
until they
I would
give us
say
money.
Get laser.
Yeah.
But you know what I mean? Like just go in for the laser treatments. Like don't, just shave it down.
If you have a very, very hairy back, I don't, dude. The waxing is too much. You get ingrown hairs.
If
you have what me and Josh have, which is like a kind of peach fuzz, and maybe some like Lou was saying, some of the longer hairs like toward the bottom, but like above the butt crack. Then you go with like the man groomer thing. It just cleans it up a little bit. But if your guy's like naturally got very hairy shoulders, the problem is you get that shit waxed, it's gonna come in stubbly, and then it's gonna be like fucking sandpaper.
It's gonna be gross.
It's gonna be gross. So you have to work with what you have. And then in terms of like, let your fucking toe hair grow. It's one little detail I do. I think it's like, if you're already doing the balls, here's the problem when you shave the balls.
How close are your feet to your balls?
Balls have to do with the toes.
No. I meant to put a comma or a period between those two things. If you're already doing your balls, right? And I don't have like, I have like, you know, the hairs where it's like one here, one there, one there, right?
Yeah.
The taint's right there. Just clean it. And I don't think you should be cleaning it with the electric razor. Just, you got to use the straight razor. Because you're going to catch those fucking hairs,
no,
dude. You catch your skin, Josh.
No. I'm not putting a sharp object down into my really sensitive pieces like that. That's
shaving your butthole with a bick seems
like yeah,
itchy.
Buddy, let me tell you something. I'm such a fucking pro at this point. Never itched.
It's not itched. It's like...
She said itchy.
Oh, I thought you were
saying...
Yeah, like
the hair growing back seems like it'd be itchy.
I thought she was talking about cutting
but
it.
But this is my point. I'm a more hairless guy. So guys who are hairier, this is probably not the protocol for them. So I think the takeaway on this episode is that it is very important, and I think Christine will agree as the woman in the room, it is very important to maintain, to have some sort of maintenance,
for
but
sure,
not to go out of the wheelhouse of who and what you are. Stay within your parameters. Like what Josh is displaying right here with his number six or number four?
Number six.
Number six chest hair. It's like,
four is weird.
It
four
looks
is like, two. Four is gets,
for
then
you.
It feels like, then it feels like a buzz.
It looks fucking great for you. For me, I'm in slick mode right now because it's summertime. That's it. So everybody's going with everyone's going with arm hair. It's like I let the shit go because I'm just not that hairy. I think for what Lou's saying in terms of like a little bit of the back hair, that man groom was perfect for him. If Lou had fucking a carpet on his back, I don't think that's the way for him to go.
But I also think you need to talk to your significant other.
Yes.
You really should talk to the person that you're with.
Or a psychologist, if you're like me.
He's like, doctor, can I get some Klonopin and some tips about what to do about my butthole?
By the way, exact conversation I have with him.
Shay's so publicly into Bush, wouldn't it be funny if I was like, I go bald.
Do you? Do you?
No.
But you take it down a bit.
Oh, of course. I have a whole routine for everything.
This is a whole other episode to talk about what guys actually like. Yeah, I think that's...
We save this.
Yeah, because there's like... This is like... Dude, I could go... That's a two-hour conversation about Bush, no Bush. About what we want between, like, the women.
And how I've been surprised, by the way. When, like, someone I'm like, oh, I wouldn't have expected... what you've brought here. But let me just say, now I'm into it. Sometimes I've been with a woman, I'm like, oh, this girl's letting things grow wild and naturally, and I've become a bushman. get my machete and lip balm, because here we go. Do we want to get into some questions on this?
Can we do one at least? Do we have time?
Lou created an email account for us. Lou, where do we want them sending questions moving on?
Want them to send it to himbospodcast@gmail.com.
Himbospodcast@gmail.com. That way you can like really express yourself with us and give us a little backstory if you want to send us before and afters of things like that. We can get into it with you.
I love that. I love that idea. Yeah. Like, you know, tell us what your thoughts are, what you guys do for grooming. Like, I want to know what you guys do.
And what you want to learn.
Yeah. Like, just please, just all questions, nothing's off the table.
And if we don't know, we'll find out. We'll research.
Yeah.
Christine, let's get into some of these questions. What do we got?
Okay, I love this one. This is from @WestsideStory4.
Ooh.
Tank top in public. Is it as bad as all my friends who don't work out regularly say it is?
Oh, I have personal... You want to go first or you want me to go first?
I don't think you should wear a tank top in public, depending on what you're doing. I think if you're going to wear a tank top, you got to do it before the sun goes down. Like running errands, doing something like that, because one of my favorite things to do at a comedy show is when there's a dude wearing a tank top in the audience, and I'll just make up a song about like how douchey and that inappropriate it is. It's like, so daytime tank,
cool. Yes.
Daytime tank, running errands, yes. Nothing as if the sun goes down unless you're doing a beach party.
No, also, like, listen, when we went to if I go to a concert, and I know I'm going to be sweating, I'll wear a black tank like I did at the Rage concert. That's fine.
What? Yeah, but in defense of that, it was like the most humid it had been in New York City in forever.
Disgusting.
And we were on the floor of one of the most violent, energetic shows you could possibly be at.
Yeah, I think that's acceptable. I think wearing them during the daytime in the summer is acceptable. I don't think out at night, like the only time I'll wear one out at night is like sometimes instead of an undershirt, I'll wear like a long sleeve shirt, like a cool flannel, and I'll put the tank top underneath so that it could be open. But then you're not seeing my arms.
But the flannel,
that's fine,
the flannel's
right?
The star that, of that
the flannel's
show.
The star of that show.
Yeah, the flannel's covering up. So you're just using the tank top as an undershirt.
And the cool thing is if I get the low one, you get to see the strapulations of if I've done a chest workout that day. I'm not going to bullshit. That's the real reason. I'm being who I am. That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, those are real fans outside the studio.
Justin loves a deep V, dude. He fucking
loves it.
It's fucking American Apparel 08 up in Justin's house.
Dude.
Do you have one of those legalized gay shirts laying around? I want one.
But here to answer the question, listen to the second part of the question. Is it as bad as my friends who don't work out regularly think? This is what I know. The people who will shit on you for it are your friends who are like, looking hand job wearing a tank top, are the people who would never wear a tank top. So it's like that, but isn't that what the question is?
Yeah.
The question is basically, is it as bad as that? It's like, no, of course not. There's people who shouldn't be wearing tank tops, but it's like, listen, there's the Puerto Rican guys who hang out at the deli by my house. These guys have the most disgusting bodies. They're sitting out there, but they wear the white ones. They're sitting out there in wife beaters, drinking all day. It's like, that's who they are. That's cool. That's cool. So it's not as bad, but there's if you're going out at night and you're wearing a tank top and you're sitting out to dinner, come on. No, you, if you go to a comedy show in
no,
one?
No. And if you go to a comedy show in a tank top and you're sitting in the front row, expect to be made fun of.
Expect to be made fun of.
Yeah. I just think at night, now. I think shorts, I'm going to include shorts in that situation too, unless it's like, yeah. you're in the Bermudas, or is that how you call it?
Sure.
You're in the Bermudas.
You know, Bermuda. This is not a geography podcast, but yeah. We'll learn.
But I'm a himbo, bro. Did I just say that?
Own
no, I'm kidding.
It.
I'm
own
kidding.
It.
I just think that, you know, at night, cover up, during the day, anything's in play. Anything's in play. But
by the way.
But to go about that second part that yeah. you were saying, everybody should be able to wear a tank top. Doesn't make a difference.
Right.
Wait, do you guys have those tank tops made from shirts that are cut like really low so people can see your ribs when you work out?
No. I go, dude, I've got, here's another thing. I've gone through so many, I'll go on Amazon and get like 5 different brands. I can't stand when the shoulder part is too thick. It makes me fucking nuts. It's got to have the right cut to it. There's different cuts of tank tops. Calvin Klein used to fucking rock it. Now they started making them too baggy and big. But I do have to say this. There's something awesome. Like, you know how, like, a sexy black dude could wear a vest with no shirt, like, out?
Yeah.
They can, you know what I'm talking about, Lou? You know what I'm talking about? Like, a Lenny Kravitz type of dude. A Lenny Kravitz type of dude could be like, yo, he could wear, like, a leather vest. And they, like, they walk between the raindrops on this one. The shit that they can pull off
yeah.
is way different than what we could pull off. But as a white guy...
what Lenny Kravitz can pull off?
Yeah. But there's guys... Dude, even the guy who's the cook at the stand, that dude's body, the African dude who's the cook at the stand, it's like, he'll be rocking like a fucking... I'm like, dude, they can pull shit off that white dudes can't pull off with some red beads? Oh, power to you, man.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're himbos. I think they are. That's like a...
I don't think Bamba's a himbo.
What?
I don't think Bamba's a himbo.
I think he is, dude. He is shred, but they can pull some different shit off. But I think Josh, you hit the nail on the head with this one.
I think for white people, it just depends. Like if you're gonna wear a tank top, man, like what I do is I don't really own a lot of just plank tank tops.
I wear plain black
or plain white tank tops. I just smushed the word together.
I saw what you did.
What I do is I just own a lot of basketball jerseys, so that, I wear a lot, and that I think that's
different.
Fair. Yeah, but they're tank tops.
Yeah, you still can't rock that out. I have like some cool ones like that. You still can't wear that like out. It's a daytime thing, dude. It's a summer daytime.
It's a daytime thing.
Can we do another one, Christine? Please.
Yes, this is from Daniel Penrod 11. When it comes to fitness, how do you two view and construct your workout plans and schedule?
Oh my
God. Do you
do
whatever you feel like when you just show up, or do you have a set layout you follow?
Josh?
You go first.
Okay, so as I was saying, it depends on what I'm doing. There's times where I'm in I'm just in the mode where I'm doing a lot of CrossFit stuff, and I'll just go to the gym, show up. I'm like, all right, I'm going to do muscle-ups. I'm doing this. I'm doing plyometrics. Because I had this injury, I was like, what? There's the restraints of what I can do, and then I've had to get more creative. So obviously, there's working out for strength. There's working out for hypertrophy. There's working out for endurance. There's ways that you can combine all those different things together. Like a lot of the stuff you do naturally, Josh, incorporates all three of those. And we'll have an episode where we go into like...
real in-depth.
No, seriously. Yeah. Like I'm being honest. Like the science of like the different fibers inside your muscles and how you have to hit each one, get to failure for strength, hypertrophy, and endurance. However, I do notice this. If I write down the workout of what I'm going to do the next day at home before I put on like an index card or put it in my phone, and I know it's a lot harder than what I'd want to do when I actually show up, I force myself to go through it and finish it, and I'm like, fuck, that was really hard, and I challenge myself. Because otherwise, if I'm just in, because I could go in there and just fuck around and still have like a great one because I know my way around the gym. But if I focus and I'm like, yo, I'm really going to make sure I hit like 8 to 10 of these things, 4 sets of each, I'm going to work to failure, do drop sets on each one, and I make myself do it. I may change things up based on like, you know, what's available in there, but I'll follow through on that, and it's that much better.
Yeah.
But I don't always do it. You?
I do 2 things every time I'm at the gym. I do a strength portion up front, and then I do a Metcon for like the last half hour. So the first half hour, well, first of all, I warm up. You got to warm up, everybody. Then
how?
I go.
How do you warm
up? I row for 500 meters. And then I stretch for 20 minutes. And then I do like 10 to 15 minutes of some form of Olympic weightlift. And I try to swim. I always.
Like a clean and press?
I do. That's. No, I do like squats, or I'll do back and front. on different days, and then I'll do like chest press, I'll do shoulder press, and I'll do, and then I'll do a lot of like cleans.
So you're doing big movements, big complicated. Yeah, you're doing, and then you're I doing do, complicated movements.
And then I check. There's a, I have a bunch of trainer friends I work with, and I, and they send me workouts. Or there's a lot of really good Instagram accounts.
Yeah, dude.
That have
Damian
really.
Patrick is the man, dude.
They have a. There's I like Proving Ground, and they post a lot of really good Metcon workouts. I think it just depends on what you want, because I don't do any actual, like...
You don't do
like,
muscle groups.
I don't do... No, you don't. Do I do everything at once. I try to get everything done. I was really lucky where I worked with a lot of trainers and in Los Angeles at doing CrossFit for 9 years. So I just know how to work out, and yeah. I know what my body responds to. I think to the listener that asked this question, you just have to figure out what your goal is. And I think you know, if you have to maximize the hour that you have in there more than anything, you know? And so I think.
But you're in there longer than an hour.
No, I'm not. I'm in there less
like
than an
you
hour.
Schedule your workouts like a CrossFit class, because that's exactly what we do in CrossFit. It's like you have a warm up. You know, whether that's like stretching, it's usually like mobility, and you either row or jump rope or a handstand, and then you go into Olympic weightlifting and then the Metcon. Yeah. Like, that's exactly how CrossFit class
and it's
runs.
That's why I did it for 9 years, because it just worked for me. It's like it's very easy. You have to figure out what works for you and what your body responds to. And I got in such great shape from doing functional fitness that I was just like, I'm going to keep doing it, but I'm not going to like kill myself and do, you know, like an hour long workout.
There's also, can I say this? Here's also the issue. Like, there's also, so when you're doing a lot of weight with quick movements, so there's also a lot of thrust to it, that's where you get the most injured doing like CrossFit and plyometric type stuff. That's where, like, I was doing muscle ups like crazy, and then my shoulder went out. My leg is completely unrelated. So I had to switch things up and start being like, all right, these are going to be vanity workouts where I'm just doing muscle groups, which is something that I didn't really do before, but I was limited to what I could do. So I think it mixes up. Someone else asked this question. They were asking me about like rep ranges, and I like actually got back and forth with this guy. I was like, well, what are you trying to accomplish? And then he was like, oh, well, I lost 30 pounds and now I'm trying to get strength, but I want to get bigger, but at the same time keep my body fat down. I'm like, the science of knowing how to do all these things and how specifically to do them and targeting like what you're trying to accomplish from a physical standpoint, from a biological standpoint, and also from just the look standpoint, we could go on we'll go on and on about this thing. But I think the point on this one is like, when you do plan something out, it's like now you got to hold to it, and it makes you, when you're tired, like toward the end, you're like, all right, let me just finish these last two things. If you're in there fucking around, even if you're getting shit done, you're going to leave when you feel like leaving.
I don't think you, but I think my opinion is, I don't think you should fuck around. I think you should go in.
No, I was agreeing with you.
Yeah, you should go in with a plan of what you're trying to do and push yourself. Just you can
push yourself.
Yeah, you can push yourself.
Mark Wahlberg would push himself.
Drink some pre-workout, get your fucking energy up, and fucking go for it.
Yeah,
man.
Dude. Oh, you do? Oh, people ask about pre-workouts. Oh, I don't even want to get to that yet.
That's a whole different thing.
I don't
thing,
even
dude.
Want to get
I think
to
we're
going
to have like workout month.
Yeah. Workout. Oh, dude, we got to wrap this up, man.
We really do.
We really got to wrap
this
up.
God, this is going to be fun.
Josh is going to drop some philosophy on us.
Let's do plugs.
Let's go to plugs. You want to go first?
Yeah, you go.
All right. You can follow me on all social media platforms at I Am Justin Silver. Saturday, September 17th at 8 p.m., I'll be in Perryville, Maryland at the Fifth Brewing Company. I'm going to be with Robbie Bernstein, who's a lot of fun. Then I'm going to be in Utica, New York, September 23rd and 24th. For tickets, go to IamJustinSilver.com, and I'll have a bunch of shows in the city. I'll probably be doing Funny for Fido, my charity event, before then. Myself and Natalie and Cuomo have Anxiety Attack at the Stand, but I always throw those things on social media, so that's the best place to follow me. Josh, what you got?
Josh at Josh Adam Meyers on all social media. You can go to joshadammeyers.com for all my tickets. September 9th and 10th, I'll be headlining the Funny Bone in Albany. September 12th, I'll be at the Comedy Store in Los Angeles doing a Shimmy Shimmy Ya. And then you can see me in Toronto at Just for Laughs September 23rd through the 25th. And check out my podcast, The 500, on all platforms, where I'm going through Rolling Stone magazine's list of the 500 greatest albums with famous people. It rules. Like, this rules.
This rules. Before we get out of here, Josh, why don't you drop some himbo philosophy on all the Himbros and Bimbros?
How should a man be capable of grooming his own horse or of furbishing his own spear and helmet if he allows himself to become unaccustomed to tending even his own person, which is his most treasured belonging? And
with that,
was Alexander the Great.
All right, everybody. Thanks so much for listening to the first Himbos podcast. So much more to come. We will see you next week.
We are the Himbos. We are not Bimbos. We